Along the rivers of Britain and around her coasts are hundreds of miles of docks and harbours. The Port of London begins at Gravesend. Ocean-going liners and cargo boats from all over the world come up the Thames to London. Some of them have come from the tropics. They may be carrying dangerous diseases. As soon as the ships arrive, they hoist the quarantine flag. And in response, the customs launch goes out to check the bill of health. After the pilot, the first man alongside every incoming ship is the customs officer. It's an advantage to be an island. It makes it easier to keep out plagues and epidemics. Now the ships carry on upstream to the docks, Galleons Reach, Woolwich, Rotherhithe, and the Pool. This ship has come from America. She's on her way to Victoria Dock to unload tobacco. Hundreds of tons of it pass through the warehouse every month. Under the watchful eye of a customs officer, every cask is weighed. The rate of import duty to be paid depends, amongst other things, on the moisture of the tobacco. This the customs officer finds out for himself. Meanwhile, the ship's captain, with his agent, is on his way to the customs at Adelaide House by London Bridge. Ship's captains of every nationality come to this office to make their reports. It is called the Long Room and has given its name to other such rooms in custom houses all round the country. Accidents at sea, drifting mines, wrecks, icebergs, anything of interest that's happened during the voyage must be reported here. The most important thing the customers want from the captain is a detailed list of the cargo he's been carrying with the entries they received from the importers. When the captain has made the report, the papers are signed. Tobacco has been weighed, it will remain in the warehouse for some years to mature before it's taken away to a factory. Over 400 million pounds a year comes to the exchequer from import duties on tobacco. This is the biggest single item of the revenue from customs and excise. Another of our largest imports is petrol. Millions of gallons of it are handled in oil storage depots up and down the country. The customs officer at an oil storage depot keeps a check on the contents of each tank with a plumb line. The storage of the nation's oil supplies is not an easy task. There are very few places where anything so inflammable can be kept with safety. Yet it takes up so much room. Some of these great tanks hold more than 3 million gallons. Even this is less than a day's supply for the whole country. Some of the larger depots, there is a refinery where crude oil is made into lubricating and diesel oils and petrol. These are carried all over the country by road, rail and water. A smaller, more specialized import is wine, which produces only a few million pounds a year for the revenue. Casks of port and sherry come to London Dock just below Tower Bridge. A customs officer has to measure them and work out the exact amount of wine in each cask. This is called gauging. It's a job which requires great skill. All the casks are handmade, and so they're all slightly different in shapes and sizes. London Dock is the pool. Overlooking the pool is the London Custom House. This was the headquarters of the London Custom House. This was the headquarters of the Customs and Excise Service until 1940, when it was bombed and they moved to Citygate House in Finsbury Square. At Citygate House, the work of customs and excise officials up and down the country is coordinated. Any questions about the rates of duty to be charged are referred to this office. And here, the policy that guides the service is laid down. The work of the Board of Customs and Excise affects the lives of all of us. Over 50 million pounds a year comes from the entertainment tax alone. Most of it from the cinemas, some of it from the seat you're sitting in. Another 180 million comes from purchase tax. Almost everything we buy, we pay customs duty on if it's imported, or excise duty if it's made in this country. In every distillery in Scotland, an excise officer is stationed to watch the entire process of distilling. Like the gauger at London Dock, he measures every cask separately and takes a sample to find out the amount of alcohol in the spirits. Excise duty on whisky and gin produces over 60 million pounds a year. In the breweries, as in the distilleries, an excise officer is always on duty. Beer is made of a mixture of water, malt, sugar and yeast. Before it ferments, the excise officer measures the quantity in each vat and tests the specific gravity. Every brewery is subject to excise control. This is to make sure not only that the duty is paid, but that the quality of the brew is maintained. There is another side to the work of this branch of the civil service, the prevention of smuggling. All round the coast, the water guard are stationed. It was they who were first alongside the ship when she arrived. Now, a party of the water guard, known as a rummy, have gone on board to search for hidden contraband. The water guard know everything about ships, cargoes, sailors, and the ports they come from. They may pay several visits to a ship during a single stay in harbour. They search everywhere, above decks and below, in the cabins, the holds, the engine room, the ventilators, and in the boats. Things the rummage crew find are trivial, and the fines paid on them are only a few pounds. But if this petty smuggling were not kept down, it would soon get out of hand. The rummage officer must be a bit of a detective, for after he's found the goods, it's his job to find the culprit. On aerodromes, as well as in ports, the customs men are constantly on duty. Thousands of people who travel, only a very few are professional smugglers. The customs officers must watch for the little signs that give them away. Will be confiscated, and this man will have to pay a fine of three times their value. And so the revenue builds up. 1,000 million a year, one third of the annual revenue of Great Britain.